Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at the color picker. So the color picker is a little window that allows you to select a color. And you'll find that many apps use the standard Mac color picker rather than implementing their own. Sometimes they do a combination. For instance, here I am in TextEdit and I've selected some text and I want to change the color. And in the toolbar there's a little color chip there. I can click it and TextEdit has its own little color selection thing where I can select a limited amount of colors. Or I can click Show Colors, which brings up the color picker. And this is what it looks like. So it's just a big black circle here because we have black text, and if we want to change that to a color, we've got this bar here that goes from black to white, and if we shift down we can see the colors appear in the wheel. So this is called the color wheel here. And if I go something like all the way over to white here, you can see I've got very bright colors available, and I can click anywhere in here or click and drag to move around to select a color. So I can choose almost any color I want, and if I need darker shades I just simply move the slider over here and I can select darker shades. I also have the eyedropper tool. If I click that I get the special tool and I can select anywhere on the screen anything I like as the color. So I can look at the background here and select this is the color, and you can see how it jumps to select that color there in the color wheel. Now the color picker also has other modes, and what modes are available depends upon what app you're using and what it allows. So for instance, here in TextEdit we've got these sliders here, and we can go with a grayscale slider to choose any gray, red, green, and blue sliders, and here we can actually even set the values from 0 to 255, or choose a hex color, which if you do any web development you're familiar with those. If I wanted to make this a little more green, a little more red, I could just slide these around. CMYK, if you're used to print publishing, you'll be more familiar with that than RGB. And hue, saturation, and brightness. That's very useful, say, if you were to select a color and say, hey, that's great, but it's too bright. How do I make it darker? You can go over to here and kind of change the brightness to something dark, maybe desaturate it to make it a little less red. So these can be useful as well. Other modes are simpler. You can use color palettes here, and you can just simply select a color by name. And you can choose different palettes, like for instance Web Save Colors. You can choose crayons. Very easy. You also have these available here in this one, where you can actually choose from a pencil and choose that color. And you have this spectrum view here where it's this big rectangle filled with colors, and you can click and drag in there to select the color that you want. So no matter which one of these you choose, you can save colors. Let's say you pick the perfect color for some text and you're going to be reusing this color in a project you're working on a lot. You can click and drag from this rectangle here into one of these slots and it saves it. And let's do another one here. Let's create a light green, and you could save that. And now instead of having to find that color again, which you probably never be able to find that exact same color again, you can simply click these little color chips here to select one. Now I said that you're going to see the color picker in lots of different situations on your Mac. So here I am in TextEdit and I've used it. But let's switch over to Preview, and let's say I'm going to create an annotation and draw a circle, and you could see it's got a color there. I want to change that color, and here's the button to do that. I have a quick color picker here just like in TextEdit, but I can go to Show Colors and you can see the color picker appears. I can adjust it just like before, and the color chips that I set in TextEdit are available now even though I'm in a completely different app. I could also go to a non-Apple app. Here's a third-party image editor, Acorn, and I can draw here. And if I wanted to change the color of the brush, it brings up the color picker as well. And I've got the same abilities here. It even gives me an extra little thing here where I can set a hexadecimal color code. So you can see how these can change depending upon what app you're in. But usually you get the color wheel and the sliders and the pencils and a few other things. So I can select that, and now when I draw you can see it uses that color, and it makes it very easy to do.